We are using this TI-84 calculator to fit an exponential model for this data, okay? And the way we are going to proceed is that we are given that it's that our dependent variable is, or explanatory is, the number of years since 1995. So for the sake of convenience, we shall change these values to the values since 1995. So let's just do that. So here is our t. So t in here will be what? 5, then 10, and then of course we have 2004 minus 1995. We got 9 here, and see, I made a mistake here. It should have been a 0. This is a 5, and here I automated it. 2004 minus 1995 is 9, and so this is 12, 15, and 18. So we are going to work with these values in the calculator. So let's bring the calculator back. So what we are going to do is, first we are going to enter this data. So we go to stat, edit, and we have to clear these values. So let me go there as we are used to. Okay, so we say clear and enter. They are all out. And again, we set clear, enter, and they are all out again. And I'm going to very quickly enter these for you. Okay, so 12, 15, then 18, all right, and then here we have 3,500, 4.3, 5.6, 7.2, 9.2, and 11.2. Okay, so we have our data in, and all we have to do is now find an exponential model. Okay, so we go to stat, and then we are going to go to calc and going to look for exponential in here. So let's keep going down. So we got exponential regression. So this is what we would like to choose. And our x is in L1, our y is in L2. Some of your calculators may not show that menu, so don't worry about it. Just go to calculate, and here is our model, okay? So what I am going to do is, I'm just going to tell you that how will you write this model. So give me a second. Okay, so here is what we had, right? Okay. And this was our output from the calculator, okay? So, and so our equation will be what? Y equals 3.259 times how much? Times B is 1.069, and depending on how much do we really want to round to the context, and here is the power x. Often, well, in this case, we are using the power t. This gave our excuse me, input variable as x, but we will use t. So that's how we write the equation from here to here. Okay, so let me know if you have any questions. All right.